Paying bills is an unavoidable aspect of daily life that many people find dreadful, particularly when it comes to paying their heating bills during the cold winter months. One might assume that people residing in warmer regions would also face high air conditioning bills during the summer, but astonishingly, the cost of cooling a home is generally less than the cost of heating one. This is puzzling, especially because both heating and cooling technologies have become more energy efficient, and natural gas, the most popular heating system fuel, is cheaper than electricity. So why does it take more energy to warm a house than to cool it? To understand this, we need to start by understanding the mechanism behind both heating and cooling systems. Heating systems come in various forms, such as furnaces, boilers, heat pumps, space heaters, stoves, and fireplaces. The most prevalent type in North America and Europe is the furnace. In a typical forced air furnace, the natural gas or propane in the burner is ignited, warming a heat exchanger linked to a flue. The warmed exhaust is then blown out through the house's vents, thus warming the rooms. Even though natural gas, a cheaper fuel source, is utilized in these systems, a considerable energy input is required to generate and maintain the high temperature. On the other hand, air conditioning systems primarily operate on electricity, a less efficient and more expensive fuel. The gas must be converted into electricity and then used to run the air conditioning system, a process that results in waste and increased costs. Despite the higher price of electricity, it is the lower energy requirement that makes cooling cheaper than heating. People generally like to keep their houses around 74 degrees Fahrenheit, a temperature considered to fall directly within the realm of room temperature. To achieve this during the summer, the air conditioner must lower the temperature by an average of 13 degrees. During the winter, however, the heating system must raise the temperature by an average of 46 degrees to achieve a comfortable temperature. It's clear that the larger temperature difference requires significantly more energy to overcome, contributing to the heftier costs of heating. Returning to the functioning of both systems, there is also a fundamental difference in how they operate. A heating system creates heat, which demands significant energy, since warm air cannot be obtained directly from the environment and must therefore be created. This process of transforming gas to electric energy, and then subsequently to heat, is resource intensive. Conversely, cooling a house requires a machine to move the heat, extracting it from the house and simply replacing it with cool air, resulting in a more efficient cycle. Air conditioning systems have also made more improvements concerning energy efficiency than heating systems, according to HVAC industry insiders. Besides, heating systems greatly benefit from effective insulation, such as double-glazed windows, attics, walls, and tight seals on doors. Despite this, heat loss is inevitable, and more energy is subsequently required to restore the temperature. Meanwhile, when a door is opened on a hot day with the air conditioning running, the AC system can stabilize the temperature more rapidly and with less energy. In conclusion, the overall energy demands and costs associated with heating and cooling vary largely based on geographical location. However, on average, heating bills are likely to be higher than air conditioning costs. This is due to the need to combat colder temperatures in populated regions, coupled with the physical differences between creating warm air versus simply moving it. Despite attempts to lessen heating costs by only warming a room when it's being used or by applying proper insulation, heating will inevitably demand more energy and thus incur higher costs. If you enjoyed this video, we'd love to hear from you in the comments section. Your feedback not only supports us, but also helps our channel reach more viewers and continue to grow.